Hello, Patrick Walchuk, and we want to give you an update on an example of a property that's sold, and we'll walk you through the financials. In this case here, it's a sale that occurred in the month of July 2017, and it was a 6-unit building in Sandy Hill. So this property sold for $1,500,000, and it had a scheduled rental income of $137,520, and when you deduct 4% for vacancy and bad debt, that gives us an effective rental income of $132,000. So the total operating expenses on this property are $49,000. And just for your information, this takes into account the management and the maintenance on the property as well. So again, that's $49,000, gives us a net operating income of $82,766. So when you divide that into the selling price, the cap rate on this property is 5.5%. Now that is actually very high, or very good, especially in what's considered a blue chip neighborhood like Sandy Hill. You don't expect to see that. So when we look at how good is this investment in terms of dollars that go into your pocket? So if we go in with a 35% down payment, and I believe I used a 25-year amortization rate and a 3.2% mortgage on that property, the down payment is $525,000, and this is the mortgage of $975,000. Yes, I'm sorry, I got ahead of myself. So that 3.25% mortgage, that's the ADS, or annual debt service, and that means that you're paying $56,881. So when you deduct that from your net operating income, that gives you a very healthy annual cash flow of almost $26,000. So here's your investment, which is your down payment, $525,000, and this is how much you put in your pocket, which is a very healthy ROI of almost 5%. You don't see that very often. So anyhow, this is what it is, and it was a very nice location in Sandy Hill.